You might think that antidepressants are only good for your brain. After all, people take them for brain stuff. Depression, anxiety, OCD, and so on. But there's research to suggest that antidepressants may be able to help with stuff all over the body. Stuff like cancer? Yes, really, we do not clickbait around here. Here's how this would work and how it could start helping people soon. There are several different types of antidepressants, and they work by adjusting the balance of neurotransmitters in the brain. Each of the medication types might have different side effects, and people might respond better to one antidepressant over another, even within the same class. For today, we're just going to talk about the two main types, MAOIs and SSRIs. MAOIs were the first antidepressants on the market. The acronym is short for monoamine oxidase inhibitors, and as the name suggests, it works by blocking an enzyme called monoamine oxidase. The usual function of monoamine oxidase is to break down neurotransmitters in your brain, like serotonin and dopamine. While every neurotransmitter is complicated, these two very generally are involved in helping you feel good, so you might think, hang on, I need those. But breaking them down is an important part of maintaining balance and making sure you don't get too much of a good thing. But sometimes you don't have enough of the good thing, and monoamine oxidase is slashing too many of your feel-good chemicals. Well, that's where the inhibitor in MAOI comes in. The MAOIs basically say, good job, enzyme, but that's enough for now. We're going to keep some of these neurotransmitters around. Now, MAOIs aren't super specific about which neurotransmitters they affect, so this can sometimes cause unwanted side effects. Over the years, scientists have developed new antidepressants with fewer side effects, but plenty of people still take MAOIs to treat their depression, especially if those other meds haven't worked out. One of those newer types of antidepressants is the SSRIs, short for selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors. And you might already be familiar with some of these, but don't worry, I am getting to the good stuff. We just got to explain real quick. SSRIs work by blocking the protein that's usually responsible for vacuuming up all of the serotonin in your brain. By preventing it from being whisked away, all that serotonin is now free to keep binding with your neurons without interruption. Same idea as MAOIs, it's about adjusting the balance when it needs adjusting. Since SSRIs work pretty specifically on serotonin, they don't have as many side effects, which makes them a good first choice for treating depression. But neurotransmitters, including serotonin, can have functions outside of the brain, including important roles in cancer cells. Told you I was getting there. For example, scientists have found that serotonin is an important regulator of the anti-tumor response in your immune system. In 2021, a group of researchers published two papers that found that MAOIs could help suppress tumors. Now, fasten your seatbelts, because there's gonna be a lot of back and forth here, but it's gonna make sense by the end. One form of monoamine oxidase, called MAOA, is expressed more in the immune cells that are supposed to fight cancer. Imagine your immune system is made up of a bunch of cars that carry different immune cells all over your body. Some cars will fight an infection over here, some will drive over to any cuts or scrapes you have, and many are just cruising around keeping an eye out for anything that might pop up. MAOA is part of the immune system, but it also interacts with neurotransmitters, crashing into molecules like serotonin and dopamine and destroying them. And under normal circumstances in the immune system, MAOAs stop your body from attacking your own cells. But your immune system isn't the only one on the road. Tumors also have their own immune cells that can find ways to bypass your patrol. Some of these tumor immune cells are called tumor-associated macrophages, or TAMs. These TAMs work for the cancer to promote tumor growth and inhibit any of your natural defenses. When your immune cells recognize a tumor, the tumor takes this opportunity to turn your MAOA to the dark side. Now, instead of just preventing the immune system from attacking your healthy cells, the MAOA stops your body from attacking the tumor as well, and boosts the pro-tumor action of TAMs. Hence the MAOIs. Remember, the I is short for inhibitor. The inhibitors kick the MAOA out of the driver's seat, so it can't do the tumor's work anymore. TAMs can't stop MAOIs, so MAOIs bring everything back into balance and make the tumor vulnerable again. To sum up, normal immune cells bad for tumor, tumor turn immune cells into good for tumor, MAOI turn off bad immune cells, bad for tumor, good for us. To verify the role of MAOA, the researchers made mice that didn't produce MAOA at all and found that those mice were really good at keeping tumors under control. In that paper, they also showed how tumor-induced MAOAs found in those hijacked immune cells prevent your immune system from fighting tumors. In the process of MAOA's usual role of breaking up different neurotransmitters, it produces highly reactive oxygen molecules as byproducts. This is usually fine in small amounts, but when the tumor cells are increasing how many MAOAs are expressed in your cells, it creates too reactive an environment for your cancer-fighting cells to handle. The TAMs, however, thrive in the chaos. It's literally creating an environment that's so toxic your immune cells won't want to work there. Which, fair, I wouldn't want to either. But the researchers didn't stop there. In a 2025 paper, they went on to apply the same concept to SSRIs. This time, they used SSRIs to more specifically target serotonin transporters in the nervous system, and the SSRIs were able to wake up the anti-tumor immune cells to go do their job. And just like in treating depression, the more specific function of SSRIs meant that the researchers found all of the great anti-tumor results of MAOIs, but with fewer side effects. Now, antidepressants aren't really being proposed as a standalone cancer treatment. Rather, it seems to be like a good option to explore as a boost for other treatments. One type of cancer therapy, called PD-1 inhibitors, seems to be a promising candidate for this boost. PD-1 is a protein that works with your immune system. When it binds to the surface of a cell, that's basically a signal to your immune system like, everything's good, this guy's with me, nothing to see here. But some cancer cells are really good at binding to PD-1, which makes them basically invisible to your immune system. So PD-1 inhibitors can stop PD-1 from binding to other cells, revealing the imposters to be targeted. When PD-1 inhibitors work, they work great, but the treatment only seems to be effective in 20 to 25% of patients. And while more research will be needed, the initial studies have found that both MAOIs and SSRIs seem to boost the effectiveness of PD-1 inhibitors in mice. Now, for the weirdly good and practical part of all of this. About 20% of cancer patients already take antidepressants like SSRIs. As I can attest to, having cancer can make you pretty sad. Well, it seems like this could help those patients' outcomes in a way we didn't even know about. And having so many cancer patients already on antidepressants provides a golden opportunity, even if it doesn't feel so hot. The study population already exists to compare the combination of SSRIs and PD-1 inhibitors to other treatment plans. Researchers could start that clinical trial like yesterday. The people are already out there. Not only that, but since we already know the safety profile of MAOIs and SSRIs, we can more safely consider whether they would fit as part of more people's treatment plan. A safe drug you already have is better than one you have to invent. Even though we still need to do more research, we have SSRIs and MAOIs already. We know how they work. That removes a lot of barriers to using them to treat patients. It's a way that we could start helping people really soon. And that is the farthest thing from depressing I've heard all day.